In 2012, Israeli acupuncturist Karen Asselin traveled from Tel Aviv to the U.S. to attend an Acupuncturists Without Borders Healing Community Trauma Training course. This course prepares acupuncturists to provide stress reduction treatment in communities impacted by natural or human-created disasters. Karen came with a clear intention to learn how to use acupuncture to help people in her country, Jews and Arab Palestinians alike, who suffer from significant stress and trauma. The AWB training prepared her to set up a clinic using the NADA protocol, a simple ear acupuncture technique that helps restore physical balance and emotional well-being. She took her idea to Natal, the Israel Trauma Center for Victims of Terror and War, recruited and trained three colleagues, and began providing treatments to Natal clients in March 2013. Under the auspices of AWB Israel. Results of the Natal AWB pilot project were very positive. Clients were less anxious and depressed, more focused, and could sleep again. Karen and the AWB Israel team began working with AWB here in the United States to bring the Healing Community Trauma course to Israel so that other practitioners could provide stress reduction acupuncture in their communities. In April, I traveled with several other AWB trainers to join the AWB Israel team for the Healing Community Trauma in Israel training. The training took place at Neve Shalom Wahat al-Salam Oasis of Peace Institute. Created in 1970, this is a very special community where bi-national, bi-religious families live together, providing a model of coexistence in a conflictual, divided land. The Institute provided a comfortable venue for the training, given the diversity of attendees, Jews, Palestinian Arabs, secular and religious participants. Over three training days, 40 acupuncturists, shiatsu practitioners, and naturopaths learned about trauma and how to work with it in local communities. We provided acupuncture and qigong training for trauma reduction, studied reflexology techniques, talked about social activism and medicine, learned how to create community service clinics, and shared personal and professional stories about how trauma impacts Israeli and Palestinian life. We drummed and danced together, ate together, and opened our hearts to one another. While the beginning was a bit awkward, this type of training is a very new thing in Israel, especially one that includes Jews and Arab Palestinians. We ended our time together with tears, smiles, hugs, inspiration, and hope. People soaked in the training like it was their own, were deeply inspired, and connected to the work immediately. After the training, the Israeli practitioners immediately went into action and began organizing stress reduction clinics, they call them healing circles, around Israel and the West Bank. Several practitioners began going to the West Bank on Saturdays with Physicians for Human Rights to provide treatments to local residents. Others treated men who have walked from Sudan to Israel who are interned in refugee camps near the Egyptian border. Some have set up healing circles for the Arus El Bar Organization for Women, an economic empowerment group for Arab Israeli women in Jaffa. The practitioners we trained organized these healing circles before the war between Israel and Hamas in Gaza this summer. Some of the circles were interrupted by the conflict, but many have resumed since the ceasefire in August. According to our colleagues in Israel, many more practitioners in Israel-Palestine are understanding the value of this work to deal with individual, community, and national trauma. AWB Israel has asked us to return in spring 2015 to provide more training for more practitioners throughout the region. During this first trip to the Middle East, AWB provided training to practitioners in Jewish and Arab-Palestinian communities inside Israel. We hope to offer training courses next year in the West Bank and Jordan, where hundreds of thousands of Syrians live in refugee camps. It is with deep gratitude that I offer this summary of the work that I and my colleagues have done this year, in a land that is in deep conflict and need of healing.
Hi, my name is Shiran Mikael. I live in Israel and would like to tell you about the AWB training I attended here. First of all, I wish to thank the AWB core team for coming to embrace me and my colleagues into their growing family of practitioners. The significance of this training is becoming more and more obvious as time goes by. As you probably know, Israel is a trauma-struck place and the people that live here suffer great stress. Living here can make you go quite numb, and this numbness that protects us from experiencing very intense negative emotions has its price. In fact, as we speak, we are having missile attacks, and every few minutes or hours we have to run for shelter. Although a big part of my practice is treating patients that suffer from trauma, I don't stop and think or recognize that we all suffer trauma here on a regular basis. The AWB training made me and many of my colleagues realize it on a very deep level. As the training proceeded, not only our personal trauma was recognized, we began to understand how we all carry a collective trauma caused by the stressful life we are forced to lead. I have personally been a witness of many traumatic events such as combat and terrorism. I lost friends and relatives, and in addition, the news here just won't let you sleep tight. Having someone that's not from here point this out for me created a great impact. My heart opened again towards issues that I have begun to feel insignificant. When you sprain an ankle, you have to treat it as soon as possible or you will not be able to carry out your daily tasks. But when the sprain is emotional, we tend to cover it up because the show must go on. Well, dear friends, the show does go on, and without noticing in the beginning, it starts to get to you. Whether it's anger, fear, anxiety or depression, at a certain point you realize how much it affects you. As a therapist, my life is devoted to helping people overcome the obstacles that make them unhappy. I was looking for some time to find more options to help my patients. The NADA protocol taught by AWB provided me that solution. Something about a group therapy which doesn't discuss the trauma but rather allows patients to just be with other patients and receive a simple method of treatment gives many patients the opportunity to digest and heal. I also use the NADA protocol very successfully in many of my private sessions, and some of my regular clients ask for this either combined with whole body acupuncture or as a standalone treatment. Patients that I felt aren't making progress anymore have improved a great deal. Besides the method of treatment, AWB offered us here a system and support on how to start taking this practice to our communities. It's one thing to dream about it and another to see someone actually do it. The inspiration we got led to a formation of many healing circles all over Israel. Some of us treat African refugees in the desert, some treat women that suffered abuse, some treat victims of terrorism and combat, and some of us use it to treat our families. The results are always surprisingly good. We offer them hope, and they embrace it. I really, really recommend this training and feel blessed to be a part of this worldwide family of people that care. Thank you for listening.